Thank you for giving interview to Ms. Martha. I want to talk about the humanitarian assistance. What is your view on the current humanitarian assistance set up from the ASEAN and neighboring countries?
I think the first point is that because of the troubles in Myanmar for decades, so the humanitarian assistance as well as the border trade have been an ongoing process. So there is a sort of a natural route, okay, from Thailand to Myanmar. Okay, both formal and informal trade, and also open and not so open humanitarian assistance. So at this point in time, there is already much of the flow of humanitarian aid from Thailand into Myanmar through various foundation, association, NGOs, and so on. So it's a natural thing, but it is not that convenient because sometimes officials on both sides intervene to extort money, corruption, okay, or to facilitate the smooth flow. Then the NGOs and so on have to pay both to the Myanmar authority as well as on the Thai authorities. But there is a going on thing. What is needed now is to open the border officially by the Thai government for humanitarian assistance, and for the Thai government and international community to support the various NGOs, whether it's a Burman one, the Karen one, the Karen or the Thai one, and support them so that they can send humanitarian assistance into Myanmar. That is networking and distribution things like that. So a natural one. But in order to facilitate and to avoid corruption, it's better that the Thai government declare that we open the border for humanitarian assistance. That's the first point. Second, if the Thai government decides to do so, it would be good for the Thai manufacturing industries, both big and small, because most of the humanitarian assistance, whether it's torch, lamp, basic food, ready to eat food, and so on, medicine, clothing, everything would have to be exported from Thailand. So it's good for Thai industries and Thai economy. So Thailand gain the benefit of that. And once everything is in the open, then that also reduces corruption and mafia networking and so on. And the government doesn't have to be involved officially because there are so many NGOs already working on that one. Okay? So let's just open up and there will be a sort of a natural flow without hindrances and obstacles from corrupted officials, both in Thailand and in Myanmar.
Millions of the people in Myanmar are in need of humanitarian assistance, and especially in the side of ethnic EAOs on a group control area. But I'm wondering whether the international assistance for this humanitarian aid in this war would be accessible.
Well, I think the Thai government has to negotiate at two levels. One with the NAPIDOR, whether it's a civilian or military government, in areas where the central government has access and control. Okay, maybe further south, in the Mount Hill area, then you can deal at government to government. But when you come up a bit north, okay, from the Thai side, say from Kanchanaburi to Mae Hong Son, to Tak, to Chiang Mai, Chiang Rai, then you have to go through the Karen, the Shan. Then you have to negotiate with the local authorities to facilitate, because most of the aid can go to help not only the Burman, but also to the Karen, they benefit also. So two levels of negotiation to facilitate. It doesn't make sense to negotiate with Naypyidaw if everything has to go to the Karen area. You know, you have to have the agreement and the consent of the Karenese.
But there are ASEAN, ASEAN is still holding 5-point consensus, but even though the 5-point consensus doesn't work out in reality, and also they're going through the Navy door. So how can Thailand, overcome that ASEAN common agreement?
I think one has to relook at the details of the 5-point consensus, whether they are realistic, okay? And even if it were to be the ASEAN humanitarian assistance, it would be better to go through the Thai-Myanmar border, not to go through Yangon, because most of the products, even if you have to go through the Yangon port, where would the goods come from? Singapore, Malaysia, or from Thailand? So it's better to do it on land, not by sea. So the ASEAN community or the AHA, ASEAN, also you have to work with the Thai government to facilitate the humanitarian assistance. Okay, that's second, for humanitarian assistance to be more effective, then ASEAN has to tell the Thaprador to stop the fighting, ceasefire. You cannot provide humanitarian assistance as much as possible under the artillery and the fighting and so on. So the ceasefire should come as soon as possible. Then humanitarian assistance could go more. But if still there is some fighting, some humanitarians can go, but it must have the tacit agreement and support of the Thai government to work with the various NGOs. And you can list up how many NGOs along the Thai-Myanmar border, how many NGOs in Mesot, hundreds of them, in Masarien and so on. So it's not difficult to find out who's doing what and so on. Then we can talk to the Karen, to the Karenni, and maybe in certain area, we talk to the Myanmar military authority.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Yeah.